Go. There. Get up. Go. There. Go.
Keep going. Keep going now. Keep going. I'll catch up with you. To the right, Sasha, the right. There. That's it. Whoa! Just stop right there.
Go!
We must go our separate ways now, Sokolova. According to instructions, I'm giving you 160 kilograms of wheat. If you go straight ahead, it'll take you to the station.
Mm-hmm.
You'll take the train to Moscow from there.
Thank you very much, Ryuto. There's one thing I must ask of you.
Andronov.
Yes?
I have a job for you to do. You're going to help Sokolova get the wheat to its destination.
But I can't, Ryuto. It's not...
You'll take care of the wheat and the girl, or you'll answer to me. Understand? Well, good luck.
All right. And thanks for the pretty package.
Tell me, Ryotov, what's the name of the station?
Ryotov!
Hey! Come on! Go!
With this weather? With these terrible roads? And that beat-up automobile out there?
It's the only way, Grisha. We can't be sure of the railroad. You know what the situation is. The gold must be delivered to the People's Finance Office.
And as quick as possible.
Yes, without delay. Be careful if you go by Gorodok. I'm sending two men with you. You may need them.
Demi.
Zolyakov.
Get in the car.
Right.
Demi. Are you deaf? Go on.
He was wounded in fierce fighting last year. He paid a very high price.
If he... well...
No ifs about it. You'll deliver the gold and come back here. That's it. Good luck.
Goodbye, then. How's the car coming along?
It coughs a little. But we have enough gas to get us to Moscow.
Well, that's a good start.
What route do we take?
Well, follow the railroad as close as you can.
We'll go through Gorodok, then.
Right.
This is where we separate. Well, good luck.
Yeah, good luck to you.
Thank you for everything.
Goodbye now.
Keep up the good work.
He's a strange one. He seems old, long before his time.
He's very unhappy.
You can't blame him. When he went home yesterday, the house was empty. His whole family died of typhus. No family, no loved ones. He's alone in the world.
Bread, gold, and pistol.
Perhaps you should take a rest.
Quit being so stuffy, Olga. Anyone would think you were a bourgeois lady.
Well, it's just that it's what I'm used to.
Oh, it's what she's used to. You know something? I don't like the sound of that. How did you get into the Komsomol? Why are you in the supply section? Well, what about your parents? Well?
My mother was an actress. And my father was a doctor. I'm not a member of the Komsomol.
I was right. I knew you weren't. I could feel it. Don't worry about it. While we're together, I'll take care of your education. Only in our spirit. The spirit of the proletariat.
Will you now? Perhaps you will.
Your bourgeois smile isn't going to work on me. So don't bother. Ryotov, why did you give this to me? This pretty package. Denikin is off to Moscow, and I'm left with this. Where are you off to now? Damn her anyway.
Sasha Antipov. Vasilya. Kolya. Kolya Gludov.
They were friends of yours.
Yes, they're from Ryotov's detachment. All massacred. Bastards who did this. We gotta get going. We don't have time. All right, let me do it.
There's one thing I'm curious about. Why don't you belong to the Komsomol?
Well, you see, Sasha, when they formed the Young Communists, I was already in the Bolshevik Party.
You what? What are you talking about? How about that? How is that possible?
Like that?
How like that?
I joined the party in January 1917.
January 17, 18, 19. All right. Go on, no! Go on, ho! Olga, you're not mad at me for, wondering about you, are you?
Not in the least.
Well, that's good.
Yes, yes, come in. Come right in. Sit down.
I'm sorry. I've got a cold. They say it's supposed to be good for it. What can I do for you?
I must get a train to Moscow quickly.
Miss, I'm afraid that there's not much I can do to help you. There won't be any train leaving for Moscow until tomorrow morning.
I'm on a mission.
Yes, miss.
Here. You better take a look at this. This paper was signed by Lunacharsky. And please, would you mind not calling me miss?
All right then, Olga, I won't call you miss anymore, I promise you. However, the train won't leave any earlier.
Please help me. I'm transporting some wheat for children. They'll starve if they don't get it soon. Every minute counts.
Olga, you and I know that. But there are thousands dying of hunger and disease every day. If it were possible, I would cure every one of them myself. I have a medical supply train immobilized. I can't even evacuate the wounded. However, I'll do everything I can for you.
Thank you.
What's this, a bribe? Is that what you're trying to do? And it's in Tsarist currency.
It's some medicine. It's my grandmother's sure cure. The money's the only thing I had to wrap it in. It's for your sore throat.
Are you in charge of the Gorodok station?
That's right. We can give you some tools to work with. That's all. And if it's impossible to fix the car, it'll have to go by train. Excuse me. Oh, there's nothing to worry about. Why don't you just relax? Haven't I seen you someplace before?
I don't think so. When is the first train leaving?
Oh, not before tomorrow morning.
Can we have some hot water?
Yes, I'll see to it right away. Would you like some tea? There's sugar in the drawer. You can sleep here. I'll sleep in the telegraph office.
Thank you very much, Stepan.
Make yourselves at home.
Thank you. Japan! Kolya! What's the matter, Kolya?
Track number 4! Where the auxiliary unit is stationed. They blew up the rails.
What?
Moscow's been cut off from us, Stepan.
Kolya, Kolya! What are you saying?
The whites.
Did you say whites, Kolya?
Stepan.
Kolya! Kolya!
Gold is inside. 3 ingots. Take it to the People's Finance Office in Moscow.
Yes, but what about you?
It's all over. Go on, get out. Go on, you hear? Get going!
Hurry. We've got
better stop when we get to the turn. We've got to check it out. You never know. There may be some whites there.
I can't see anyone. I heard something.
What's the matter? Don't you like the water? Come on. It's
There's four at the most. It should be easy. You and Olga get on the handcar. We'll sneak down to the wagon and then open fire on them. You'll see we'll knock them over just like sitting ducks. Let's go.
No need to take the risk. It could be a bloodbath. I'll sneak on around and approach from the station. Maybe I can catch them unawares. You come from the right. Mm-hmm. And don't fire unless you have to. Understand?
Yes.
Bring the handcar here. Wait for my signal.
All right.
Let me go with you.
It's too dangerous. Here, take this.
Move on. Well, what do we do now?
You were asleep, Daniel.
Look, he's drowning. I suppose you think you can impress me by drowning your own men.
That's enough, Sasha.
Leave me alone.
Come on. Lock them up in the wagon. Then go get the handcart.
All right, get your hands up, you no good rotten bastards, in the name of the revolution.
Easy, Sasha, take it easy.
What do you mean, easy? We should shoot these no good rotten bastards.
Let's put them in the wagon.
Come on there. If I were in charge here, I'd have you all shot. Rotten whites.
Now I've killed a man.
War is war, and this is war.
The water's still rising. You think we'll be able to make it out of here?
We're in a hollow now. It'll get better further on.
You saved us, you know. Without you, we'd be...
Where are you going?
Right now, I just want to get out of here. Then on to Moscow.
We're carrying wheat.
Sit down, we can go now.
Where are you going? Would you like to come with us?
Get on, friend. The more the merrier. Let's go.
This is the place. The whites were here this morning. Looks like no one's here. Quiet. There's no one, thank God.
Let's get to work.
Once we cross through this zone, things will change. You'll be quiet after that. One, two, three.
Beautiful.
Hold it! Don't let go. That's it. Careful, you'll crush your feet. Yeah. Put that down. Slowly now. That's it. Put it on the ground. You were holding your breath. Now you can breathe. Hands up. Hands up, I said. It's the best way to relax your muscles. That's it.
There's a woman with him.
Yeah, not bad.
Hey, you there. Why are you looking at me like that? Think you scare me, huh? Well, you don't. Ah, you stupid ass. Idiot. Who do you think you are? Leave it. Talking to you isn't getting us anywhere. Understand me? You better. We won't repeat ourselves. So listen.
Who are they? And tell me about the train.
Let's go over one thing at a time, Arkady. First of all, by last night, you'd already left for Gorodok. I was out on the railroad line with my men, waiting for the train from Moscow. All of a sudden, there was an explosion. In the woods. We went there, and what did we see? Five gentlemen officers who had just blown up the track behind the red lines. And that's why we didn't catch the train we were expecting. Now, I ask you, please, to excuse me for what I did when I saw that, Arkady. But I was so furious that I eliminated the first three. Then I brought two of them here, officers of the 10th Cossack Cavalry. Lieutenant Morozov and Second Lieutenant Smyslov. They were carrying a whole case of explosives. They didn't have time to use them, though.
May I point out to you, Mr. Miazentsev, that in this box there are armed explosive detonators. They can easily be set off. One little spark, and everything here will be blown to dust.
You're absolutely right. I won't stand for anyone playing with explosives, Nikita. Take this away to a safe distance. Stop. Bring it over here. This is first-rate imported pyroxylene. The same kind I use. The day when I blew up the safe at the Orlov Bank. Gentlemen, comrades, I'm known to everyone as Arkady Miazentsev. It's possible that you've heard of me. The Russian press has often mentioned me between the last revolution and this one. There was the armed holdup of the mail train near Nikolaev, the robbery of the Kharkov Bank, It seems I'm a very dangerous criminal condemned to death. I'm the Mizentsev, just escaped from prison again. Etc., etc. You've met this one already. Pasha, a gypsy, my protege. He specializes in railroad operations. And this one. He has his future cut out for him. I'd like to point out that I stay far away from politics. For your information, I am completely indifferent to your opinions and objectives. The whites, reds, anarchists, and the others don't interest me unless they're capable of helping me get my hands on material goods that I need. You can see why I'd like to find out where and when and how it's possible for me and my men to find these goods we want to get our hands on. I want you to think about it while Pasha tells me all he knows about you. While I'm waiting, I raise my glass to your health. Shall we get down to brass tacks? Gentlemen officers, there are some questions that I'd like to ask you. Very shortly, the Reds will take Gorodok once more. You are a long way from your rear lines. The Cossacks are searching every house in the area. For what or whom are they looking? I think you know. And what about this stupid attack just now? What was the reason? What good was it to blow out the line to Moscow? Shall we start with you over there? First Lieutenant Morozov. What have you got to say?
Mr. Mizentsev, I'd prefer talking to you alone.
Go on, speak. I'm listening.
But there are not only your people here. Perhaps you'll say afterwards I shouldn't have told you all this in front of everyone that's here now.
Start talking.
Gold.
Shut up, let you go. Bastard.
The answer to all your questions is 60 pounds of gold in 3 ingots. When Colonel Bragin learned that there were a group of Czechists that stopped off in Gorodok to wait for a train that was going to take them to Moscow with the gold they were carrying, Bragin decided to cut the rails and lead an all-out attack and take over Gorodok and get the gold for himself.
It always turns out that way. There's always the intelligent one who wants to be smart. You rotten bastard! Away with these idiots. Take them to the outskirts of the woods. I'll bet you couldn't imagine how many dogs are wandering around those woods. We hear the howling at night, poor things. They must be starving. They give me such a headache. I can't sleep these nights. Oh, Pasha, continue.
I never saw any train. What did I see? All I saw was a handcar. And on the handcar were those four. Well, the gentlemen officers, at least they were wearing gold rings. However, with the Reds, it was a different story. They're so poor that all we could get were 3 sacks of wheat and another sack full of tools. They're really down and out. Zaitsev, step on. It says you're the station master at Gorodok, not a party member. Olga Sokolova. She's the headmistress of a children's boarding school in Moscow. She lives at number 1 Ordinka Street. Member of the Bolshevik Party, sent on a mission to find wheat for the school children. Alexander Andronov, sailor in the Red Fleet. Komsomol, accompanying Sokolova. Here we have Gorbach Vladimir, and he's a member of the Cheka, Bolshevik, being sent home for medical treatment. He has a revolver with the following inscription. To the best of the Czechists. Signed, Dzerzhinsky. How about that?
Can you tell me how it is, Gorbach, that Dzerzhinsky presents you with a gun and you flee shamefacedly away from the whites in a handcar? Not heroic. Why didn't you act bravely and get killed, defending the town? Well, my good Reds, you've heard talk about this gold. What have you to add to the subject? Who do we begin with?
With me.
With you. Speak then.
I've nothing to say.
You must be joking. Did you see what happened to the preceding jokers?
Yes.
Aren't you afraid of death? Will you look at that, Pasha? He didn't blink an eye. He's either a hero or completely insane. If it's the pistol you're after, don't bother. It isn't loaded.
Mm-mm. Give me a light, will you?
Of course, Gorbach. With pleasure. You amuse me a lot, do you know that?
You amuse me too? And now would you please load your vehicle with the 3 wheat sacks?
You're joking, aren't you?
No, I'm not joking. Just look at my right hand. You will raise your hands now. Go on. My friends and I have nothing to lose. You'd never let us out alive. If you make one move against me, I'll blow us all sky high.
Yes, I believe you would. Pasha. He's liable to do it. He's completely insane. You men there. Yes, you men there. He can do whatever he wants with us. It doesn't make much sense to tempt our own fate. Pyroxylene's very dangerous stuff. Load those sacks into the car. Then get as far away as you can.
Sasha.
Yes. And why are you standing, huh? And you give me those little toys there. That's it, catch it. Here.
You've got just 30 seconds, Miazentsev.
Catch up! Catch up! Fire!
How is it down there?
It's like this. On the right is the barrier. Cossacks on the left. Now, when the grenade explodes, you'll go to the left. Got it? I'll be stationed right around here.
Be careful, Sasha.
Don't you worry. I know this village.
Where'd they go?
I don't know.
Well, we'll have to keep on looking. Come on.
He's drawing
them
away.
That's Sasha. It's Sasha.
He's doing what has to be done.
Hurry.
Get in quick!
Oh, he's really scared! What's wrong with you, Sasha? What's happened? Sasha? Sasha? What is it, Sasha? What is it? Huh? What? Sasha! Sasha! Did you see? There's blood on the wheat bag.
You can relax now. Just make yourselves comfortable. I'm going out to stand watch. You never know.
He's a fine man. He has a good heart. What are you doing that for? We're a long way from the front now.
Must be a habit.
Vladimir, I was wondering. Do you have a family?
I did have.
I'm sorry. So now you're looking for death, aren't you? Isn't that right?
Not really. No, I want to live.
I want you to promise to look after yourself, for my sake.
Sack. We'll put the wheat into it. This one here, right? It's in the worst shape. What's this?
Where are you? Stefan, where are you? Stefan! Stefan, where are you?
right here.
Stepan, what have you done?
May, I haven't done anything. It's you. Don't move, Vladimir. Stay where you are. Well, now, what have you done? Why don't you have to stick your nose in there? You should have gone to sleep, you fool.
Gone to sleep?
Why not, Vladimir? I would have taken the gold with me. I would have gone home quietly without causing anyone any trouble. And now, what will I do now?
Nothing. We'll just take the gold along with us to Moscow. And return it.
Yes, only I didn't endure all these hardships with you and the others just to give it all back. Why? Why should I? And why should I let my children grow up in an orphanage? I want them to find a place in society. Why shouldn't they?
In that case, you had better go over on the other side, Zaitsev. We're the whites.
What are you talking about, Olga? The whites lost the battle long ago. I'm all for the Soviets, you know that. And I've always been. I want them to stay in power. Only a Gram will always remain a Gram, no matter who's in power.
You are a pig, Zaitsev. You're just a filthy, rotten swine.
That's right. That's right. Go on, insult me. Go on, say something mean, vicious. It'll be hard for me if you don't. Give me a reason. Well, now go on, spit in my face, why don't you?
I'm not afraid of you, Zaitsev. I know you wouldn't dare do it. No!
Olga.
Really? I would, you know. Vladimir knows it. I'm sure Vladimir is convinced I would.
There you are. You better get going, Zaitsev.
No, it's not over. I've got to kill you. I'm sorry, it's the only way out.
No! Can't be! You're dead! I shot you myself, Gorbatch. You're dead. It's not possible. No, it's not true. You're right. I'm no good. Oh, now, we'll split it between us. Go on.
Take one, go on. Why don't you speak? You want two? Then take two. Why are you so silent? Tell me. Look, do you want it all? Is that what you want? No. No, no, you can't. Not like that. Why? Why don't you speak? We can come to an agreement. Wait. Let's talk it over. Don't shoot. Yes, you're right. I'm rotten to the core. Not you. You, well, you're a good man and you're honest. You wouldn't shoot me, would you? I'm not armed. Please don't do it. I want to live, Gorbatch. No! No! No!
People's Finance Office.
You there. Wait a moment. Where do you come from?
That's not important.
Well, what's your name? Your name, what is it? Tell me.